be useful for additional boxes on top of the thing. But I said it sold 12.
Well,
and then the next day you sold.
Let's just, like, really, to answer my question, we can just look at, okay, these 2 days. I'm telling you that the pattern is like this consistent pattern. Every day you sell the same number of boxes. How many boxes per day would that be? And if you know that it's 4 or you know that it's some other number, how do you determine that? That's the big question. How do we know how many boxes we're selling every day? Sienna?
Okay, so I was
doing
this shower yesterday.
Of course.
And
some good math happens.
Exactly. So I did it like this. I did length. So I imagined what 8, so I did 8 minus 24 basically.
Wait, 24 minus 8, right?
24 minus okay. 8. There we go, sorry.
Now, what does 24 minus 8 tell us about this days and boxes of cookies situation, Jackson?
That in between the 1 and the 5, or 4 days in between.
Okay, so we don't know 4 days yet because we're not quite there.
But 1
but
plus 4 is 5.
Okay, in those 4 days, what's happening? So 24 minus 8, what's happening?
You get 16 days, so 16 boxes.
Okay, so it, from day 1 to day 5, you sold 16 boxes. That's what 24 minus 8 tells us.
Yeah, and so I did like 16, and then because I took the days and went 1 day minus 5 days, 4 days.
5 days minus 1 day.
5 days minus 1 day is 4 days. So I divided them and got that 4 boxes could be per day, maybe.
Well, does it make sense, 4 boxes per day? I mean, we're forcing this days and boxes thing on it, but it works well enough.
Yeah.
Well, 24 boxes minus 8 boxes, right? Mm-hmm. 5 days minus 1 day. Well, that's 16 boxes that we sold in 4 days. So, and it just so happens 16 is divisible by 4, so we sold a convenient 4 boxes per day. Okay? This next question here is really kind of a future question, but I mean, if you kept track of how many boxes you sold at the end of each day, would it necessarily work out to a nice round number of boxes per day?
No.
No, because maybe you sold 4 the first day, 5 the next day. That doesn't work out nicely.
And like
4 and a half a day.
Yeah, but that's what we're doing. That's how it's going
to
work.
That's how it's going to work, because we want it to work out nicely as we maybe step our way up to more complicated things. So 4 boxes every day.
Mm-hmm.
Is that useful information?
Yeah.
Useful information. How do we use that information to figure out how many boxes we've sold by day 26? Somebody who has not spoken yet. We've heard from Tiana, we've heard from Carter, we've heard from Jackson. Jackson pointing at someone, I don't know who it is.
Anyone?
Oh,
no person.
I don't like meeting random people.
Alec? Oh, I thought you said you don't like random people.
You had your hand like this.
Oh, no, I was just doing this so I could do my hair, but I guess so. Okay, let's just do it. Okay, so what's the question?
So now we know that we're selling 4 boxes per day. How does that help us figure out how many boxes we sold a day?
We can use a formula to figure that out.
So we can write it, just go right to writing a formula?
Yes.
Okay, tell me how to write this formula.
25 times 4
plus 8. Okay. Now technically that's not a formula. It's an expression.
Sorry. Expression, I get them mixed
okay.
up.
But he's right. Is he not right?
Yeah.
He's right. Why? So someone explain why Alan picked 25. Because
it takes 25 steps.
Yeah, so day 1, going to day 26, it takes 25 days, 25 steps.
So you just simplified that part.
Right. Times 4, why 4?
Because that's rate of change.
The rate of change is how many boxes per day. And why are we adding on 8?
Because that's the first box.
That's how many we had on the first day that we sold. So take our 8 that we already have sold, right? Kind of, this seems like there's a bit of a boost there from Mom, right? Like day 0, she already bought some boxes.
You already bought 4.
And add on all of the boxes that we've sold at a rate of 4 per day for 25 days. Right? And so that gives us how many? That's pretty easy, right? 25 times 4 is conveniently 100. That's pretty easy. Plus 8, 108. So by day 26, sold 108.
All right. So a lot of boxes.
If we're doing some staring off into space, maybe it means we're just totally rocking it. We don't need any help. And it was just kind of boring for us. But if we're staring off into space because we kind of feel like we're not quite getting it, we should do less staring off into space, more writing things down as we work them through together. Because what you have here, a nice example, right, of something that I'm going to consider us having talked about. So we'll talk about this less and less. We'll talk about more complicated things more and more. So don't miss your opportunity to write down some good examples of what we already talked about. So I'll raise this question mark while perhaps more people write this down, and we will say definitively on day 26, 108 boxes were sold. Could we take it a little further? Could we write a bona fide formula that for any number of days into the future, I can just plug that number of days in, and I know how many boxes were sold that day? At least say yes, because we feel like I'm just saying things that, of course, we're about to do, right?
Yes.
So, yes, we could write a formula.
So, I think a formula would be F.
Did you have a formula?
I think that.
Okay, so let me just write down Y equals
of X, and then in parentheses, X minus 1, and then plus X.
A lot of X's.
Okay, so the reason why I did that is because all numbers can change throughout, like,
well, we'll write it for the specific problem. So specifically day 1, we had 8 sold. Specifically 5 days, 3/4 sold.
Yeah. So
does that change things a bit then?
Yeah, so okay. The rate of change would be the first one.
This would be the rate of change?
Yeah.
Which is?
Which is 4.
Okay.
And then the one in parentheses is the day.
The day.
So in this case it's 26.
Well, we'll let the days be the thing that can change.
Yeah.
Okay.
One is depth. And then that one will be 8. Because that's how many boxes are.
Formula. Do you guys think about that formula?
Yeah.
Right.
I got another one.
Yeah. We got a different formula. What's Caden?
X.
Pretty much. X.
Times 4.
Times 4. Okay, I'm just going to write that as 4x, if you don't mind.
Okay.
Okay.
Plus 4.
Plus 4. And where did that 4 come from, Caden?
Because I started at 0.
Yeah. I started at 0.
You started at day 0? Like the day you, as a Girl Scout, got your forms, right, ready to sell things, and mom was like, okay, I'll buy 4 boxes. Day 0, 4 boxes. And at the end of day 1, we sold 8, and we were selling 4 a day.
What?
You were a Girl Scout.
Yeah.
No, she's going to be a Girl Scout. They're honorable people.
Yeah.
Wait, but wouldn't you be a Boy Scout?
Oh,
so you want those cookies?
All right.
Now, all right, we crossed over that thing where we're talking funny for a second, and then we're just all going off the deep end with Girl Scout discussion. All right, bringing it back. We're bringing it back. Here, let's make this a little smaller and talk about how we can go. How we can go from the Carter's formula to Caden's formula and not have to work very hard at it. Okay. Stand by. No.
Is that a B?
Do it. That's a Y. You know that. Don't mess around. Okay, so we can create Caden's formula from Carter's formula just by doing some math, right? How do I multiply this 4 by the parentheses x minus 1?
Distribute.
Distribute. Distribute the 4, we get 4x minus 4. There's that plus 8. Y equals 4x. What's negative 4 plus 8?
4.
4 over. Okay. Oh, yeah. That kind of just shook itself out there. The 4 represents the number of boxes sold on day 0. Then we add on from there. Add on 4 per day. Okay, how did that seem? We're getting good at this without me. we're working our way up to writing linear functions, something we've tried to do before, had some trouble, but you guys are doing great now. So let's try again. Let's try another example, and you can write a story about it, like days and boxes of Girl Scout cookies if you want, or don't. It doesn't really matter, right? People will come up with different stories and they will all probably work, okay? So let's bring up another page. Let's make up another example. Let's say, we'll do some crazy like day two. Why is, now I'm ready, making a day, it doesn't have to be day two. 15, then delta x is 7. So I'll start with Emma.
162.
Okay, so you just got an answer right off the bat.
Oh yeah, that's what you wanted.
I would like to hear the reason. So how'd you get there?
I found out how many go up. Like I went from 15 and I counted like every time until I got to an equal number up to 7. Like I counted like.
Oh, so you like counted by twos? You counted
by
twos.
And then I like tried all that. Too,
okay.
And I got, it goes up by 3 every time, and then I put in 1 so that I could go from 1, which is 12.
Okay.
And then I did 3 times 50 plus 12,
okay.
And I got 162.
Sounds good. Sounds very good. So it sounds like maybe the first thing you noticed was that, can we use days and boxes of cookies again?
Yeah.
Okay. So you notice the first thing, it seems like, is that 5 days had passed, right? Because then you use that information to try and count up by the same amount to get from 15 to 30. So, okay, I got to count up 5 times. I'll try counting by twos, right? 15, 17, 19, 21, that's the, yeah, it didn't work. Then we count up by threes. If I go up by 3 5 times,
it works.
It gets up to 30. Okay. So you're trying to figure out, see if everybody agrees. Emma's trying to figure out how many boxes get sold every day. This is what we like. We want a rate. Right? This is a rate. Boxes per day. It's the rate of change. Boxes per day. Okay. So certainly that's completely a valid way to figure out how many boxes are sold per day. 5 days go by, let's count up by the same number until we go from 15 to 30. Right? Is there a little bit more of a, I guess a little bit less of a guessy way to go about it?
Yeah.
How do we go about it? Just kind of more, you know,
15,
more relatively. What's that?
13, or 15, 30, 30, 30,
30 divided by 15.
30
divided by
15?
30 divided by
15. I just do what I'm
doing. Oh, okay.
But
well, okay.
I think it has to be the
expression. It certainly seems like it.
Yeah, I got it.
So here's, let's say, all right, so like 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, 5 days go by, right? And we see a total of 15 boxes be sold. We want to divide that 15, that gain of 15 boxes, into 5 days. That's division, right? That's what you did. I mean, you did do division. You just did it in a little bit of a different way. But this way, we can do it the same every time, and we don't have to do as much of a guessy thing where we have to count up by the same amount each time, even though it's exactly the right concept to have. So we divide that 15 up into groups, into 5 groups, right? Each group is a day. And of course, that's 3 here, 3 here, 3 here. We just took 15 boxes and divided it by 5 days that went by. And 15 happens to be divided by 5, which is really a thing. And we come out with 3. Boxes per day. Notice the boxes are still in the numerator, the days are still in the denominator, 3 boxes per day. Okay. So then, let's just pick back up with Emma's story. You backed it up to day one, because you know three boxes per day. So backing it up to day one. Well, see, if three boxes get sold every day, then we should, if we're going back in time, we should take away three, which puts us at 12 boxes. So we can start with 12 and add on so many days worth of three boxes per day. How many days go by between day one and day 51? 50 days go by times three boxes per day, and that's 162, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Do we have to start at day one?
No, you can start at day zero.
You can start
at day zero. You start at day two.
Yeah.
So, you'd have to.
You have a question.
Kano flips list. I thought that, like, depending on what day you started on, you get a different answer. Because I started on day two, and I got 165.
Because you probably did 50 stuff.
Yeah, I did 15.
But you have to do.
I did
49.
49, because how many days go by between day two and day 51?
49
days, right?
But then would you add on 15?
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, because you start with 15. You start out with 15. You add on 49 days at three boxes per day.
Yeah, it's 162.
So those both get the same answer. Now for day X. We can write these formulas however we like. We can start from day one, we can start from day zero, we can start from day three or day seven, and write the formula from there. The difference is going to be how many boxes we start with on that day, and how many days go by for whatever day. So, Emma's approach, we start on day one, well, we start with 12 boxes.
Oh God.
Okay. We're going to add on three boxes per day. Now it's just a matter of how many days go by between day one and day X. How many days go by between day one and day X? X minus 1 days. Let's do what Carter was talking about. Let's start on day two. Well, we have 15 boxes plus three boxes per day. But how many days go by between day two and day X?
X minus
2 days. These get the same answer. We can show that they get the same answer by distributing. What have we done today? 49?
51.
51! That's better. 2 more minutes.
We have to flip
it. Y equals 12 plus, I'm just going to distribute the 3, 3x minus 3. Y equals 12, or no, I'm going to do 12 minus 3 is 9 plus 3x. Okay, now we'll look at this one from the person who started from day two to write their formula. Y equals 15 plus, distributing the 3, 3x. 3 times negative 2, negative 6. Now 15 minus 6, also 9. 9 plus 3x. We got 9 plus 3x in both cases. Who might have written this formula right off the bat, 9 plus 3x? And why did you? Like, because you started
at
0. Okay. Now the nice thing about the day zero formula, you tell me, what's the nice thing about the day zero formula? It's a little less work, right? There's not this subtract 1 or subtract 2 or subtract 3 from x first and then multiply by 3. It's just the number of days, because when you start on day zero, the number of days that go by is the same as the number of the day that you want to go to. Times 3 boxes per day plus 9 boxes that you started with. Great. Not all. Okay, so let's see if we can do a couple more. I'm going to give you, I'm going to go with 3. Last one's going to be a little bit of a head scratcher, and work on it for the rest of the class, and if you don't get done, then just bring it back for homework. All right, so let's say that we start with x is 5, y is 9, and we're at x is 13, and let's see, that's 75, okay, we go to x is 47, and ask the question how many are there, but also write a formula.
Not that.
Next one.
There's two?
There's three.
What?
I said that just 1.5 minutes ago. Three. 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, class.
Oh.
Last one will do. Why? Number three, and you do what we've done for the last few examples, and you think Mr. Stewart must have made a mistake because something is weird here. I meant for it to be weird, so don't think, well, I won't continue because this is too weird. Some weird thing happened. Okay? These two, fairly nice. Okay, they work out nicely. This one, slightly tricky. Okay? I'm going to throw you off that it's a little weird.